Please welcome back to the stage your SYTA president, Alex Urdaneta.
Hello, hello. Buenos dias. Good morning. How your conference is going? Good. How about that incredible musical last night? What was your favorite character? It's not Pumbaa and Timon anymore. It's the Wildebeest and the Lady Bird, right? So Elton John and Tim Rice did an amazing job of writing the music for the movie, and the adaptation is incredible. Last month, a couple of months, when Courtney and I were invited to be in The Lion King on Broadway, I just couldn't believe it. Wow, what a great experience. I thought maybe I get to be a giraffe, tall and elegant, or an elephant, strong and big, or a cheetah, fast and smart. When I arrived in New York City about three weeks ago, for the fitting, for the costume fitting, I got a very big surprise. You want me to be a what? A wildebeest, ugly and scared. They always are scared. And in Spanish, it's called new, which is even more, it's awful. New, new. Anyway, then I call myself down and ask, how many people ever have this opportunity to be surrounded by world-class artists, to step on a legendary stage, and to be in the middle of the action? And I convinced myself that I would be the happiest and the best wildebeest in that Africa. And it felt like it. It felt like it. That my role in that diversity of animals, of all colors, all sizes, and all appetites, was the greatest opportunity ever. Thank you, Nicholas, and the team of Disney on Broadway for this opportunity. And I want to talk a little bit about that opportunity. It is a great word that comes from the Latin opportunitas, which is first known use in the 14th century, and originally used as a term for convenient. Of course, today the term defines as a favorable juncture of circumstances. And I want to reflect on this concept because this is one of the most regarded aspects of mine and hopefully your work. It is at the core of our industry of student and youth travel. Everyone in this room, in one way or another, provides the chance for young travelers to not only participate, but to truly learn and change in a positive way through travel experiences. Leading this organization with that in mind was a meaningful and serious commitment. In regard to the opportunities I have been given personally, it has been a great privilege and honor to have served as your SYTA president this year, an organization of which I am deeply grateful. I appreciate my quick ascent to lead your organization, and thank you for allowing me to be your first Hispanic president. Thank you. My first opportunity and support were provided by my family, my mother, Ada, 90 years old, and going strong, traveled by herself everywhere, every continent. She taught me the importance of loving God, my neighbors, as well as the value of hard work and love for family, among hundreds of more things. Thank you for my husband, John Kevin. He's been very supportive. He's been my rock and my best friend for 16 years now. And of course, the best English coach on the planet. If you're able to understand what is coming out of my mouth, it's all John Kevin. Many of you have had the opportunity to meet our stellar company team from Viajes y Plus in Puerto Rico. They are my most precious treasures. So thank you guys for being here. We are four members here. It's Anitin Vargas, Anita Molina, Andres Urdaneta, and Carlos Garcia. Thank you very much. During my term of presidency, they have supported my SYTA work in many ways. Getting to know and work more closely with other members of SYTA has been such a blessing and opportunity for me. Thank you for your generous giving of time and your endless energy. And of course, we are blessed to have the incredible leadership and support of Catilena Sante and the team, the staff of SYTA, Katie, Amy, Henry, and Deb. Thank you all so much, and let's give them another round of applause. Most of us have learned over the years that opportunities don't just happen, but then sometimes they just fall into your laps. In that spirit, I want to recognize two friends who were responsible for finding the opportunity to engage with SYTA and the board. First, Michael Cibrizzi. You should remember Michael. I first learned about SYTA by him here in New York City when he was working for the Empire State Building in the mid-2000s. And I was leading a tour in the building. And then Shannon Carter, a former SYTA president, encouraged me to consider leadership opportunities in SYTA. Shannon, thank you for that conversation that day in the pool in El San Juan Hotel in Puerto Rico. It was a fun and sunny day, right? That day in the pool. And yes, amiga, all of this of me here is your fault. And I'm very appreciative for that. It has been a great journey, and I will continue my involvement with SYTA. The amount of colleagues, friends, and partners that I have had the opportunity of knowing and sharing time with during this year has been incredible. This has been an important investment, and I hope to continue to be of the service to your association. I give those two quotes on the screen for you to read because I want my time as SYTA president to be a reminder of the power of student travel. As the stormy times of the pandemic are becoming more and more behind us, new opportunities are emerging, opportunities to create new and different experiences. Let's understand that this opportunity should be given to all young people, regardless their economic situation, the language they speak, their appearance, what they believe in, or how they identify themselves. And I had that opportunity when I was a kid in my marching band, which has changed my life, and it has changed the life of many others. This also underscores how important the work of the SYTA Youth Foundation is to provide opportunities for young people in the future. Let's support those opportunities with vigor and generosity. Finally, the nickname El Presidente will remain with me as a beautiful memory of having collaborated with an association that is open to diversity, positive change, and planned growth. It has meant... I wasn't expecting this. It has meant a world to me. The last word is thank you. Thank you. Gracias. I can't believe it. I couldn't say the last word. Thank you very much. It was a pleasure. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.